I'm Bruno Paiva from the University of Navarra in Pamplona, Spain. At ASH, we are presenting an abstract entitled Integrated Multidimensional Flow and NGS to Reconstruct Evolutionary Patterns from Dysplasia to AML. I think we can all agree that clonal evolution in AML originates long before diagnosis and is a highly dynamic process. And it is important from a biological and clinical point of view to have greater understanding of leukemogenesis. However, dissecting leukemic transformation in patients with newly diagnosed AML is challenging without single-cell technologies. Yet, most clinical laboratories do not have infrastructure to perform single-cell studies routinely. Now, how to overcome this limitation? Well, we thought that, as many would know, patients with newly diagnosed AML may present with dysplasia. And if these residual mature dysplastic cells were generated before the differentiation blockage of blasts that precedes leukemic transformation, it could be hypothesized that studying the genetic landscape of dysplastic cells and blasts in the onset of AML could uncover the evolutionary process from dysplasia to AML. And this was the rationale behind this abstract, using more available techniques such as flow and targeted sequencing to reconstruct clonal evolution from dysplasia to AML based on NGS on sorted cells after the identification of dysplasia in newly diagnosed AML patients. Well, by using this, or should I say, before we describe what this strategy offers from an applicability point of view of this hypothesis, of this concept, we first analyze the frequency of dysplasia detected by flow cytometry in a series of almost 300 patients. And in 89%, we detected dysplasia. This means that this concept, if useful, could be applicable to almost 90% of newly diagnosed AML patients. I should say elderly AML patients. Then by performing targeted sequencing of recurrently mutated genes in MDS and AML in the blasts and in the specific dysplastic cell lineages, we found we were able to identify three different patterns of leukemogenesis. One, stable transition in the patients displaying identical mutational landscapes in blasts and residual mature dysplastic cells. A second one of clonal selection in those cases where blasts originated from leukemic stem cells other than the ones driving dysplasia, due to mutations absent in blasts but present in dysplastic cells. And a third one that could be described as clonal evolution in patients showing new mutations in blasts onto mutations shared between blasts and dysplastic cells. This was observed by combining flow with targeted sequencing, using the same approach by flow, but doing whole exome sequencing. It obviously provides greater amounts of data. We were able to show that, in fact, the three patterns of leukemogenesis coexist, usually in the same patient. Therefore, and to conclude, I believe that we showed for the first time that it is possible to reconstruct leukemogenesis in nearly 90% of newly diagnosed AML patients using techniques that are commonly available in clinical laboratories around the world. And we do believe that the possibility to identify the genetic drivers of leukemic transformation and treatment resistance could be clinically meaningful to develop tailored treatment strategies aiming at the eradication of genetically diverse leukemic clones. And the reason we say this is because we found that the evolutionary patterns are different between the transition of MDS into AML and between AML diagnosis and the MRD clone persisting after treatment.